that this is not a real band. We are a hologram playing for you tonight. And so we all were like, okay, who's talking? There's no leader to this band. This is a complete democracy.
I think we should all talk at the same time.
That's a great idea. That's a grand idea. We started off with one called Watermelon on the Vine, just in honor of... being here, watermeloning out. I think that's a word. So we started with that, and then we went into a tune called Bon Aqua Blues, which is on a double banjo album I put out, as if one banjo isn't enough. And then Dark Hollow. I'm sure many of you, anyway, if you're a bluegrass fan, you know Dark Hollow, and you love the song. We love it too. So we're going to have Jake sing a song for us. This is Jake Jolliff right here, in case you don't know who's who. On loan from the Yonder Mountain String Band. And we're going to do a tune that Bill Monroe, it goes back a long ways, but Bill Monroe kind of made it safe for bluegrass. It's called White House Blues. It's a tight show, folks. Mike Barnett here has a brand new album out. In fact, tonight's the official first night sale, right?
Yes, it is.
This is it tonight.
This is it.
So each and every one of you has to buy one. Even if you're a couple, give one away to a friend. It's a great album. And who else is on there?
It's... let's see. Tim O'Brien sings a couple of tracks.
Nope,
Young Kilney. Dominic Leslie, Chris Eldridge, so a bunch of the Punch Brothers. Evo Donovan sings a couple tracks. So, yeah, I was really lucky and fortunate to be able to do that, to throw that together.
So we're going to do a song from that very album right now.
The title track is called One Song Romance. Thank you.
Thanks very much. That was a tune called The Purple Trees of Colorado. A tune I wrote on, I have a fairly recent album, came out in February, called Great Big World. And whoever hasn't bought his album, you could buy one of mine. So we are going to break down into smaller discussion groups and do a mandolin fiddle number right now. With your permission, of course.
I think we're going to try another instrumental off of my CD. This one's called New Barns.
I think we're out of notes. Sorry, we're done. Then it'll leaven.
Well, we're going to do another bluegrass number.
This is one that I learned from the singing of James King.
It's one called Leaven.
Up and you put me down.
retirement by Bill Monroe, the father of bluegrass music, when he had a toothache in the 50s in Roanoke, Virginia. And somehow this song came out of the fact that he had a toothache. We're not sure exactly what led to the song. It's a great song. You know what I'm thinking, gentlemen? Why don't we, these poor people are getting just our size. Why don't we start off playing for you folks and gradually come over and then play for you folks and they're in the cheap seats over here. What do you say? Should we do that?
I think so.
I think so, you know. Sort of a commanding procedure here. Like many bluegrass tunes, it's way too fast, and we'll do it anyway. But we have to.
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah. It's only for the two of you. Well, in the. Okay. Maybe the four of you. I'm not sure we want to do the next tune. Hold on a second. It's right, it's in print. I mean, it's right there.
that Tony Rice album, Church Street Blues. It's called Last Thing on My Mind.
Song for the set. Is that too short or is it about right? We're gonna do a whole, we're doing a whole nother set, exactly the same tunes. No. We're short on repertoire now. Should I do this? I'm gonna do a pizza or something. What do you think? Yeah, just a little hamburger helper for us. Yeah. Okay. Just while we're in the folk mode, we lost a very great man this year, Pete Seeger. I just want to do a tune that he recorded on an album called The Goofing Off Suite, which he recorded in 1955. And we all think about Pete as, you know, being a great strummer. Sing along without being asked on the last time. I figured it was safe to do that. And Pete had all these different banjo styles he did, but when I first heard this version on the Scoofing Off Suite, I just almost fell over what he was playing in 1955. And he explained to me one time that he and his wife Toshi had bought a house in Beacon, New York, or just south of Beacon, New York, overlooking the Hudson up in this wooded area up on this hillside. And he said, you know, they put the house together, and then while Toshi was tarring the driveway and the kids were putting in the electrical system, he was hanging out in the hammock, noodling on the banjo. And the songs that came out of that noodling, and he was goofing off, and it became the Goofing Off Suite, which is still available on Smithsonian Folkways Records. And so I'm going to play one of the songs off that album. He did some J.S. Bach on there, and some Beethoven, and some old-time tunes, and this next song, Blue Skies, by Irving Berlin. And this is note for note, as close as I could get it. I transcribed it from Pete's playing. This is none of the modern progressive stuff. This is Pete Seeger, 2 and take a short break, and the merchandise table is open for business, and Mike will sign CDs. What do ball players charge? $50 for a...
Well, 15 for the CD and then 50 for the autograph.
Right, okay. So anyway, we'll be over there just to say hello, and so really, really glad you all came out, so thanks for being here. And we're going to finish off with the Bill Monroe tune that was actually written by Earl Scruggs, and it's called Bluegrass Breakdown. Wait a minute. We have to change our set list.
Tony Trischka and friend.
Okay. Dedicate this song to Warren Hellman, who for many years and started part of the Strictly Bluegrass out in San Francisco.
Can I hear you?
Now I want to dedicate the set to Warren Hellman, who was he started a Hardly Strictly Bluegrass Festival out in San Francisco. It's a free festival that they have every year. How many years has it been?
15 years.
It was an amazing festival in Golden Gate Park. I had the great privilege to do it 5 or 6, 7 years ago, something like that. Amazing, amazing festival. So he passed away recently, so dedicate this set to him. And we're going to start with a tune that's on my double banjo bluegrass album. And what I did is I took, if you know Salty Dog, the bluegrass song Salty Dog,
yeah.
I took the chords and wrote a song with the chords backwards and called it Doggy Salt. But I wasn't that happy with it. For some reason I recorded it, it's out, it's too late. And then I did a gig with Jake and another friend of ours, and I was saying, you know, this song bugs me. I just don't like these couple of chords. So Jake said, well, why don't you put in a C minor instead of the C? Oh, well, that's nice. And then we changed one of the other chords. Now I like the song. And now it's called Soggy Dolt. I know, it's pretty weird. Anyway. Okay, here we go. Thank you. like to do a Gordon Lightfoot tune for you right now. Any Gordon Lightfoot fans out here? I sense a Gordon Lightfoot presence. Not literally, but we have some fans here. And this is via J.D. Crowe, one of the world's absolute greatest banjo players on earth. And it's sort of self-referential and kind of zen-like. It's called You Are What I Am. What does that mean, anyway? You are what I am. Discuss.
One, two.
In the first three rows, we'll take your seats and just put them up against the wall. We're going to do a waltz right now. So if anyone wants to, okay, right in the aisle here or right here, maybe over there. And this is Jake's a showpiece, if you will. If a waltz can be a showpiece. From the Bluegrass State of Kentucky, it's the Kentucky Waltz, written by Will Monroe.
Kentucky war.
Rule of statesmanship, ignore the audience. Well, we're going to do a great fiddle tune that we love to play. Because it used to be just a fiddle and a banjo was a band, as Lester Flatt once said. And we kind of like to prove that to you right now. And this is called Cherokee Shuffle.
Berklee College of Music, so we're supposed to be able to play a little bit of jazz music. Which,
I love that jazz.
I spent 4 years trying to avoid trying to figure out how to play it on the mandolin. but we're going to do one of our favorite standards called Just Friends. Thank you.
we're going to do a medley of three tunes. The first is one I wrote for my wife on our 18th anniversary, and in a fit of creativity, I called it 18. No more romantic title has there ever been. And then the second tune, actually the next last two tunes are on my new album, Great Big World, and the first one's called Great Big... No, it's not called that. It's called Belated Wedding Hoedown. I knew the name of that. And then the last tune is a Stephen Foster tune called Angelina Baker. Is everybody still here? Yes, you're all here. Oh, good.
Thank you.
instrumental right now. We haven't done enough singing, and we're not going to continue to do more singing. So this is the most bizarre. There's a Bill Monroe tune called Wheelhouse, and he referred to himself as a wheelhouse, which means real hard-driving, powerful guy. And Bill Monroe was all of that and more. And he wrote it about himself, I guess, kind of another self-referential tune. Like, you are what I am what you are. Anyway, this is the most bizarre version of Wheelhouse. I don't know what they've done to Bill Monroe's song. I'm not responsible for any. I'm just playing the simple chords that Bill Monroe wrote. They're going somewhere else. I'm not responsible. Kids these days, you know? Aren't these guys amazing? I mean,
share the stage with one of both of our biggest musical heroes. Please give a round of applause for Tony Trischka.
Alright, so this is another kind of wheelhouse.
Yeah.
Let me start right from the top, right?
Yeah.
Sorry, we're new with this.
Matter comes
between the last two B parts.
Only at the very end.
It's not a big.
We're giving away the secret. The E minor chord comes in between the two parts only at the very end. Now you know. We don't even have to finish. We don't even have to play the tune now.
Thank you.
Well, we've come to the end of the row, and thank you for coming out.
Yeah.
We've had a beautiful time. Thank you. Thank you. You are so lucky to have this venue here, and we want to thank Paul for bringing us here and bringing music to you.
Yeah.
So much. Fifteen years, so keep coming back and supporting live music in this wonderful setting. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We don't need
them. Oh, jeez. We thought it was the last tune. Oh, man, this is really embarrassing. Okay, well, we're pre-ending the set. Should we do that? We'll just do it.
We'll just do it?
Yeah, we'll just do it. Okay, we're going to do two songs. But I meant everything that I just said. For sure. And I want to thank Paul's whole family. They fed us an amazing dinner, great strawberry salad, and great homemade tomatoes. They were made, you know, sea monkeys. They took sea monkeys and mashed them together and came up with these great tomatoes. I don't quite know how that works, but... anyway... We're going to do a song by Michael Martin Murphy right now. Some of you may know this tune. And then we'll really end our set. This is called Carolina in the Pines.
Spoke up.
That was the penultimate tune. This is the ultimate tune, so to speak. Anyway, thank you so much once again, and we're going to finish off with a tune from my double banjo bluegrass spectacular album. We'd like you to buy all of our albums. We paid to play here tonight. We don't even have enough gas to get home. So if you buy all of our CDs and all of our merch, then we may just make it home after we pay back Paul for letting us play here. We've had a great time playing for you folks. I'm playing in... thank you. I'm playing in Baltimore tomorrow night. Come on down. And you're playing in Portland, Oregon.
Oregon tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night. You're playing tomorrow night, right?
I'm doing something tomorrow night.
Yeah, he's playing tomorrow night in Portland, Oregon. So head out there. Where are you playing tomorrow night?
Grey Fox.
Is it the Grey Fox Festival? That's a little bit closer. We may never see each other again, but at least it's been fun tonight. Arcadia. I wrote the A section of this tune, and Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn wrote the B part. So, sort of a combined effort here. All right, so thanks again. Thank you. too hard to leave and come back, so we really, really appreciate it. Thanks so much. Thanks. Uh-oh, what? We're out of material. Oh, no. Is like another fast tune or something more mellow?
Before you answer that, let me just say that
I was in the middle of talking.
This is all videotaped by the Frontier Cable Access, your local community TV, in case you live in Whately or Conway. So you can see this concert again eventually in case you miss any of the notes. Thank you, guys.
How many want something fast? Oh, God. Let's do it like
just a little bit.
Yeah. This is just a tiny bit.
Just a little bit.
We'll do some shameless pandering here. Here's a little bit of Orange Blossom Special.
Okay.
Big mandolin hits. So we're gonna rock.
Rod?
Which one?
Loch Lomond?
I don't know that one.
Is that it?
I can't sing it. Sing it?